Shri Hansraj Bharadwaj, distinguished Chief Minister of the State, Shri Siddhi Ramaya, Shri Kimani Ratnakar, Minister for Primary Secondary Education, Government of Karnataka, Shri M.B. Patil, Minister for Water Resources, Shri S. R. Patil, Minister for IT and Biotechnologies, Shri Ramesh Jigjani, Member of Parliament, Shri Shivraj C. Kaushal, Deputy Commissioner, Cardinal R. Balaji, Principal of the Sainik School, distinguished members of the faculties, staff, dear students, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I am indeed happy to be amidst you on this happy occasion when you are celebrating your golden jubilee of the establishment of your dear alma mater, this great institution which was established 50 years ago by a band of visionaries who recognized the need of establishing such institutions, keeping in mind our past history and also the need of present requirement. India obtained its political freedom after a long struggle against British imperial power of almost 190 years. Various parts of this country, which were subjugated by the colonial power, has long traditional history of bravery, courage, sacrifice. Karnataka is no exception. But at the same time, it is a fact that out of the outcome of the devastating Second World War, India obtained independence at the midnight of 14-15 August 1947. Just 2 years ago, the Second World War came to an end and all the world powers engaged in this blood-curdling, devastating Second World War became weak because of the wanton destructions of the war. From the very beginning, India had to face and confront its adversaries, sometimes coming from within the country, most of them coming from outside our borders. And I salute the Indian brave soldiers who never let this country down in keeping their vigilant eye, in protecting our motherland, whether the border may be desert, desolated place, it may be dense forest or on the mountains, or it may be in the snow-capped mountain peak. Indian soldiers, Indian armed forces were ever vigilant and just to constantly convey the warning to our enemies, don't forget, we are alive. We are alert. They spend their sleepless nights in dense forests, in freezing cold, in most hostile atmosphere, in the desert, so that rest of us in the country, in the mainland, can sleep peacefully. Not only protecting our borders, as Honorable Governor was very correctly pointing out, whether it is national disasters, whether it is in the need of the civilian authorities to enforce law and maintain peace, Indian Army, Indian Armed Forces is in the forefront. Therefore, when in 1961 this decision was taken that we shall have to institutionalize the recruitment of young, brilliant men and women, and the decision of establishing Sainik Schools all over the country were taken, that speaks of the foresightedness of our initial rulers and administrators. They were the makers of this country. Thanks to V.K. Menon, thanks to Y.B. Chavan, thanks to Chief Minister Nijalingappa, thanks to Education Minister Dr. K.L. Shrimali, whose individual contributions in establishing the 13th Sainik School at Bijapur can never be forgotten. Today we are having 24 Sainik Schools spread all over the country. And of these, yours is one of the best. I congratulate you, all the past members of the faculty and the present members of the faculty and the present students, for your wonderful contribution which you are making over the last 5 decades.